There we posed as Bohemian Club members, thus entering the inner sanctums of the New World Order.
No, I got it, honey.
You're so great.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, that's good.
You be careful, baby.
Okay.
I don't want you to go anywhere.
Shh. I'll be safe. Don't worry about it, guys. Come on.
Be careful, Mike. God bless.
Yeah, pray for us. Keep the evil off us.
Careful.
Yeah, let him go.
Walk on up here for a second.
When's the next shuttle coming?
Inside the Bohemian Grove. We're actually not inside yet, Mike.
Well, we're in the parking lot. That's pretty...
Yeah.
Aren't they the biggest... They're the biggest, like, living thing, I think, aren't they?
Oh, yeah, they're incredibly large.
There's one up there that you can drive a car on top of one, you know?
Well, on top of it,
yeah.
Lying down?
Yeah. That you can actually...
Well, they used to have the one you could drive through.
That's also there. That's up there.
Boy, it's nice when that cool wind hits you.
Oh, yeah.
Take the rain, maybe.
Okay. Yeah. How much did the rope cost?
This thing?
No, the rope.
The rope. It was 88. Yeah, I thought you said rope.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I thought rope and rope. Yeah. Can't hear anything with this wind. Look, this thing's seen some years. Pretty nice, actually.
Yeah.
This is the oldest one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Other than maybe that little red one.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
I think when you go to heaven, they have buses like this.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, go ahead.
Let's see if we got one up here.
Yeah, is there another one coming?
So that Marty thing was like...
We don't have time in the documentary to show you an entire tour of the 2,700-acre compound in the middle of the gorge. Besides the fact we didn't even have time to see but about 20% of it in between dodging security personnel. Unfortunately, we were using digital tapes that were 1 hour. Several of the confrontations were not caught on tape. We had sheriffs, deputies, Secret Service, you name it, question us on who we were. We just told them we were with the hillbillies. That's where the bushes stay. You know, because we've got Texas accents.
Close back in the corner right over there.
Yeah,
how's it going?
Good.
Oh, this feels
Here's just one of many signs sporting French with skulls adorned with other trappings of death. We also saw signage with Latin and other ancient languages. Now we're about to let you see a little bit of what's going on with the great owl.
Getting bold.
This is the owl.
I'm getting this, Allie.
Let's get out of here.
I like that.
Here you can see the bottom of the stone owl with the altar and the eternal flame, a Aladdin lamp style urn that continually burns here around, we're told. And here's a side shot from about 30 yards away of Moloch, the Canaanite deity to which children were sacrificed to in Babylon. And yet another slowed down close shot. Again, the internal flame burning, the altar, the bottom extremities of the 40-plus foot stone deity, and there is a shot of its head as well. Again, we've slowed down this video because we only actually had about 5 seconds of it on our hidden cameras, so you can have a chance to get a closer look at it. You will see it during the ceremony. Speaking of the ceremony, we were on the left-hand side of the lake about 150 yards downstream beneath those large redwood trees. Much of the ritual you're going to witness took place on the right-hand side of the lake and at the northern tip beneath Moloch. Keep in mind the scale of the idol compared to those giant redwood trees. It's at least 45 feet tall. This is America, and it's been going on for 120 plus years in Northern California. This is not some new fad. We're talking about something deadly serious with its roots in ancient history.
We may have to.
I'm
A thirsty man. Look out.
Reagan was a turning point for us. Didn't realize at the time it was. And
anytime I shoot.
Turning point for us.
Not really.
So many liberal Democrats in their time turn things around.
Morning.
It was all lies.
Was that right?
No.
It's probably as accurate as you know.
We had already been questioned three separate times by the Bohemian Club security, Secret Service, and Sonoma County Sheriff's Department. To evade discovery, we decided to try for one of the more remote areas of the camp, according to our map, the most southerly side, and a lookout point, an observation deck over the Russian River. While Mike Hansen was watching for the sheriff's deputies that were down the path and over the bridge in a guard shack, I began to shoot the video you just witnessed. After we turned the camera off, one of the Sonoma County Sheriff's deputies showed up and began asking us why we were filming. We calmly told him we were just sightseeing as members of the Bohemian Club. The point that has to be made here, though, is they do have hidden cameras because there's no way that they would have been able to witness us videotaping from where the guard shack was located. And then upon walking back by the guard shack, we actually witnessed banks of television screens and wires leading up into the redwoods and disappearing. Also visible from the observation deck is the famous sunning area for the establishment lackeys and their pomps. Here you can see some of the fine carpeting out on the floaty. The long history of men enjoying themselves has even been written about in the gossip column of the San Francisco Chronicle, writing that a man on his own often gets invited back to the camp by gay bohemians. Even 100-year-old annals have admitted the homosexual activities. After escaping the sheriff's department, Mike and I traveled high into the hills to wait until dark and the beginning of the cremation of care ceremony. Before the cremation of care, all the Bohemian Club members begin a massive feast of revelry.
He's so pissed off at me.
After the feast, cult members travel from the main dining area under the trees out to the eastern side of the lake, where they congregate and prepare themselves to properly thank their deity, again, the 3,000-plus-year-old Moloch. The occult activities are coming up, and then after the actual ritual, we're going to give you some more of the history surrounding it. But first off, I wanted to draw your attention to the program that was given out to the spectators, or the viewers. I guess an occultist would call them novices, who actually watched as the priest and their supporters engaged in this ancient rite. Now, you're looking at a little demon called PJ that was on the front of the actual program. It's kind of in a Hieronymus Bosch style. He's got a little broom and a dustpan, and he's sweeping something up. Now, even more shocking is the figure of a human body burning in the flames. In fact, I've shown it to people that are experts in anatomy, to actual doctors, and they say that the anatomical size is that of a baby or small child. Notice how large the cranium is in comparison to the torso, that is the ribs. Understand, ladies and gentlemen, this is from the program itself given out to the establishment lackeys witnessing these sinister activities. Remember, in Babylon and Tyre, they would throw their children into fiery pits. Look at the size of the hands compared to the rest of the Mahdi. Only children show these anatomical details. Now, of course, it's been airbrushed in, but it shows the psychology. Now, this is the only skull we actually caught on tape. We've blown it up for you over one of the major meeting houses. Of course, it's not a real skull. It was extremely oversized up on the signage. The point we're trying to make here is the entire compound was literally infested with symbols of death, skulls, owls. At long last, here it is, the cremation of care unveiled.
Oh, yeah.
As we sat there in the darkness, not knowing what we were about to see in the gathering crowd, suddenly, across the small lake, we saw a carriage with men in black and brown cloaks, robes, in front and in back, bearing a bound body. Remember, it was a hidden camera and at somewhat of an angle. Something particularly pleasing was happening for the Bohemian Grovers with whatever developed with that crowd of men in black and brown and the bound body on the back of the buggy. They drove behind big black tarps they had hanging out of the trees. There was lots of smacking on lips of in bizarre enjoyment by the crowd. We still haven't made out exactly what was going on, but that a real sacrifice may have actually been developing, according to some occult experts. All the time in the darkness across the small lake, the men in black were doing something behind the dark curtain hanging from the redwood trees. Then after about 10 more minutes of music, suddenly all around the owl activity began. Here is the main central part of the ritual.
The owl is in his leafy temple. Let all within the grove be reverent before him. Lift up your heads, O ye trees, and be lifted up, ye everlasting spires. For behold, here is Bohemia's shrine, and holy are the pillars of this house.
Bohemians, with the ripple of waters, song of birds, such music as inspires the sinking soul, do we invite you into midsummer's joy. The sky above is blue, sown with stars. The forest floor is heaped with fragrant rich. Evening's cool. cool kiss is yours. The campfires glow. The birth of roses and the dawn. Shake off your sorrows with the city's dust and cast to the winds the cares of life. Let memory bring back the well-loved names of gallant friends who knew and loved this road. Dear boon companions of the long ago, aye, let them join us in this ritual. Not a place to be empty in our midst. All beauty's vassals, who hold in this gray autumn of the world or springtime in your heart, a 10-hour tale. Gather ye forest folk and cast your spell over these mortals. Touch their world-blind eyes with fairy unction. Open their eyes and pull all the memories of yesterday and seal the gates of sorrow. It is a dream. And yet, not all dreams. Dull care and all of his works are but a dream. As vanished Babylon and Ridley Tyre, so shall they also vanish. But the wilding rose blows on the broken battlements of Tyre, and walks rends the stones of Babylon. For beauty is eternal, and we bow to beauty everlasting. For lasting happiness, return to one alone, and she surrounds you now. Great nature, refuge of the weary heart, and only balm for breasts that have been bruised. She hath cool hands for every favorite brow, and gentlest silence for the troubled soul. She counsels her most wise. She healeth well, having such ministries as calm and sleep. She is ever faithful. Other friends may fail, but seek ye her in any quiet place. Smiling, she will rise and give to you her kiss. So must ye come as children. Little children that believe, don't ever doubt her beauty and her faith. Nor deem her tenderness can change your side.
Like a skull bringing the bound body across the water. Again, we'll have enhanced video of this later. And let's see if you can pick up all the different occultic meanings in the speeches you're about to hear.
plus the shadowy tide, know the ancient majesty of death. Know the arch enemy of good. Not for thee that has been tribute, for the rest will say, fire shall have its will of thee, and all the winds make merry with thy dust. Bring fire! Against thee, and some thou shalt destroy. But this too we know, year after year within this happy grove, our fellowship ends thee for a space. Thy malevolence which would pursue us here has lost its power under these friendly trees. So shall we burn thee once again this night, and in the flames that eat thine effigy, we shall read the sign, Midsummer sets us free.
Ye shall burn me once again.
Not with these flames, which hither ye have brought from regions where I reign. Ye fools and priests, I spit upon your fire.
Well, Prince of all mortal wisdom, Owl of Bohemia, we beseech thee, grant us thy counsel.
Nourished on the names of men.
We thank thee for thy adjuration.
Now we're going to get to some enhanced video, and we'll go play-by-play through some of the more occultic statements, like, we shall read the sign in your burned effigy, the bound body. That's exactly what the Druids actually did. They would roast cats, goats, oxen, horses, and watch the pain of how they died, and from this extract some type of mystical energy force or power, and also be able to tell the future.
Owl of Bohemia, we beseech thee, grant us thy counsel.
Upon further research of the ritual you just witnessed, it becomes clear. It is a mixture of the Babylonian Canaanite cult of Moloch, fused with ancient Druidic rites, where you have the female side of Satan, which they first call out to in the she, and then towards the horn god with the he, mixed with Masonic rites from Scotland. It's very likely that many of the 1,500 to 2,000 member crowd had really no idea what they were actually watching because it was thinly veiled. Here we have some more enhanced video as the boatman, again with his face painted up like a skull, pulls his boat across the small lake towards the high priest with the red of his cloak visible with his hand outstretched as if he is pulling the damned soul towards him as they throw off their cares, their conscience for what they have to do in the world. Also, you have the arrangement of the circle of higher level priests around him, the high priest in lighter colors, and then the outer rings of red, and then those in black. This is consistent with the darker workings of the occult, not just with the Western countries, but also worldwide. Now, when you see that black edge coming to the field, that's because we zoomed in on the video, and many times the picture was almost out of the screen, so that's the edge of the field or the view of the camera. We'll get back to more enhanced video of the ritual here in just a minute. But remember PJ, the little demon down in the corner, the left-hand corner of the program, sweeping up the ashes with little horns? And how can you forget this, the image of a human body burning on the altar? Again, this is what they were handing out to those that were witnessing these macabre activities. But again, from Babylon on into ancient England, the word bone fire, meaning human sacrifices being thrown into fiery pits, turned into today's bonfire. After the sacrifice, members of the cult would sweep up the ashes of the victim and use them in future rituals. One of the things that is extremely obvious by looking at the program handed out to Bohemian Club members is the person creating the program had a deep understanding of the occult.
Thank you.
all the winds that tarry with thy dust. Hail, fellowship's eternal flame. Once again, midsummer sets us free.
There you see the funeral pyre burning with the effigy of a human, or it could be real, ladies and gentlemen. There's been a lot of strange going-ons in that area of Northern California, but this is what the establishment is into right here in America, the cremation of care. And this was July 15th, 2000. These people are deadly serious, those taking part in the ceremony. Another point, the pyrotechnics you're seeing going off were being released from beneath little wrought iron crosses about a foot and a half tall. Also, notice the screams of pain coming from the sacrifice.
Be gone, dull care, and all the winds make merry with thy dust. Hail, fellowship's eternal flame. Once again, midsummer sets us free.
One of the facets of the ritual that goes deeply into the occult, again, we've already mentioned the Druids at their bone fires or bonfires, throwing bodies into fiery pits after ritually cutting their hearts out or slitting their throats. They talk about reading the sign in the burning effigy, reading the sign. Again, research your history books on the occult, even the Encyclopedia Britannica on what the Druids would engage in. This is just unbelievably macabre and evil.
So shall we burn thee once again this night, and in the flames that eat thine effigy, we shall read the sign.
Well, we're going to confront George Bush on Bohemian Grove. George Bush Jr. They've been announcing on CNN, MSNBC, on television last night and today, for the first time in history, they're admitting it, why the vice presidential decision was made at Bohemian Grove. George Bush Sr., the former president, and Golden Bowen, others. So now they're just throwing it in everybody's face. We've broken the story over a week ago. July 15th, we were in Northern California. They're trying to ignore it. George Bush is down here at the governor's mansion across the street from the Capitol, about to announce Dick Cheney as his vice presidential running mate. We're going to go blow the party for him and get the information out to people. We're not going to stop. We're getting in their face. I want to make it clear that I'm neither Republican nor Democrat. But the facts speak for itself. George Bush Sr., Jr., even their grandfather Prescott Bush, were all members of the Bohemian Club. So we drop by to, well, let them know that we're fully aware of their activities.
This is massive. This is how George Bush dresses up, right here. We got him on tape. This is how they dress up, right here, in red and black robes. A little more pointy, though, like the Klan. We got him on tape. This is how George Bush dresses, right here when he's in the Bohemian Grove. This is how he dresses. We've already put it on television. absolutely disgusting. George Bush isn't a conservative. He's not for family values. He is nothing but a Luciferian twit. A Luciferian twit, Bush. You may think you can feed on the human population. We say no to you. We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Long live the Constitution and death to the New World Order. We stand firm. We stand strong for America against your evil, Bush. And we're going to get this story out, and we're going to continue to push it, because the truth will not be that you are part of a 3,000-plus-year-old devil cult for the Al Moloch from Babylon as well as Tyre. We have the high priest admitting all this. We have it on videotape. It is documented. It is documented. A Luciferian devil worshiper. Already people all over Austin are talking about it. We're not afraid of you. We're not afraid of your minions. In fact, we're waking your minions up every day with the hardcore evidence. We know your father met 11 times with Bill Clinton in 91. The whole thing was stage managed. We understand you've been helping to sell this country out, Bush. And we're going to expose you and your Luciferian rights. We have the video tape. This is a massive story. One of the stories of the century. One of the stories of the century. How you had the Luciferian cult for 121 years in Northern California. I went inside for the cremation of care. I witnessed the entire debacle. Many of these Secret Service agents have been in. No doubt protecting these people inside of this system.
There had to be, in my belief, an occultist, a deep occultist, who designed each of the elements of this ceremony. It wasn't just a bunch of guys sit together at a bar and said, hey, let's have a good time, the cremation of care, and why don't we do this or that. I believe it was purposely designed, each element in its turn, for what they did. No doubt about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've been watching Dark Secrets Inside Bohemian Grove. The facts we've shown in this film are absolutely documented. I would only hope that the people of the world realize the organized evil we're dealing with at almost every level. Republican, Democrat, you name it. They're all working on the same team. Ladies and gentlemen, it's called world government, the new world order, dehumanization. It's not a joke. It's deadly serious. Unfortunately, they've been breeding societies to think everything's a joke. I'm here to tell you, truth is stranger than fiction.
Purchase additional copies of this film, or to see dozens of other films and important books, be sure and visit Infowars.com or PrisonPlanet.com. Or to order, simply call toll-free 1-888-253-3139.